Hi guys, I'm back with a new video and things are going to be a little bit different from now on. Just in case you were wondering what I have been up to, I spend a lot of time in the attic and in my living room trying to get rid of stuff that I haven't used for years. One of these things was a beautiful, white, expensive designer couch called Jazz. And a charity store was willing and able to pick it up and take it away, and they said they were going to make somebody very, very happy with it. So the couch is gone and I was able to remove my dining table from that corner to the front window where I'm sitting now. The window is behind the camera. And this way you are able to look into and through my cute little living room. And the bigger couch is over there. So there I am, and I have to get used to this. It's weird. But this video is about vampirism. And 10 days ago, 2 weeks ago, I don't really remember anymore, I was talking to somebody about vampirism and the things you have to consider and think about before you really start doing things, or things you should be thinking about after you just started doing vampirism. Now, I was born a witch and I was born a vampire, and it took me a while to become aware of the fact that I was a vampire, but I knew all along. Thanks to some childhood trauma and a broken back, some other weird health issues. So, what I saw in this person's technique is that I was missing some refinement. Now, I do want to share something with you for those that aren't familiar with vampirism. And some of you might think, there she goes again with her Order of the Nine Angles stuff. Some of this stuff is still useful and interesting. Not that I have read this thing. I haven't, only this part that David Myatt said or wrote. So it is in the Vampiric Aims of the Dragon Covenant. I have no idea who they are and where they are, but David Myatt. In order to sustain itself, a living causal organism, by its very existence in the causal, as a causal being composed of causal matter, must obtain causal energy in the form of, for example, carbohydrates. That is, it ingests sustenance, food, and extracts from this matter the type of causal energy required in whatever form. What he's actually saying, if you are an animal, then you have to eat to stay alive. For some odd reason, people in the Order of the Nine Angles always have this weird way of expressing themselves, which is always complicated and difficult and extensive. And let's continue, because now we are heading towards vampirism. However, it is possible to theorize, it's not a theory, that if a living organism could obtain and in some way use a causal energy itself, it might have no need of such causal matter as sustenance, just as in theory, it's not a theory, such an acquiring of a causal energy could change, that is, make more healthy and extend the causal life of such an organism. But just go back a little bit, in theory, such an acquiring of a causal energy could change, it can change, it's not a theory, it can change, that is, make more healthy and extend, but also, if you're not careful, make you sick and shorten the causal life of such an organism. And that's where we are going to talk about. One thing is, as a child, I started using vampirism and I used my eyes to look into a certain target that I had my eyes on, literally, and then I used a movement. I have no idea if you really can see this, but I am at least etherically sort of rolling my eyes upward and the energy goes down behind my eyes. So I lock in, I draw the energies in by making this backward movement and I feel the energy go through my nostrils, then the roof of my mouth and into my throat and down. And then my grandfather said that I was freaking people out, and that's true because everybody in kindergarten and later on in life was scared shitless when they saw me, or at least when they saw me looking at them. So he taught me some other techniques, which was you still look at somebody, look into his or her eyes, and then make this umbilical cord, which is now called a tendril. I agree, tendril sounds much cooler than umbilical cord, but you create an extension of your auric field that attaches itself to your target, and then you draw in energy. He said that once you have your target in mind, you can stop looking at them and just keep doing something, play with Lego or bake a cake or have fun in a sandbox or something. And as long as you keep thinking about the one you have in mind, the energy will flow towards you because you want it to. And when once you're done feeding, you disconnect, pull this tendril towards you again, make it your own, and then that's that. You can either heal the one you sucked the life out of, or you can just, you know, forget about the whole thing, depending on if you like somebody or not. So that's the eye technique. And then this is what I used for years, and it worked. It made me feel healthy and vibrant and energized, and I was able to heal a second and third degree burn on my left leg, and I was able to heal a broken back, and I was able to go through life and have good grades, and you can use it for everything. If you want to have good grades, you suck the life out of somebody that's insanely intelligent. And if you want to have some more muscle and physical energy, you pick a target that's, you know, fit and healthy. So it depends on what you need. Then you look for a target, then you take what you need or more. And, you know, so years later, I met my husband, and he had a way easier technique. When he was going through a rough time, he was just going through town, doing groceries, going to the zoo with his kids, and he would just ask bypassers, innocent bypassers, I'm so tired, I don't think I'm going to make it through the day. And their higher self was, okay, you can have 2%, 5% of my energy. And that's how he went through town and through crowds, and it saved his life. And he told me about it, and I started using it, and perfect. All this time I had this eye technique, which I still use, by the way. But I also got used to using my husband's technique, which is all about just asking. He is totally into Huna. And if you're interested in Huna, you will bump into this subject sooner or later. Silva, mind control, things like that. You just ask, can I use, if you make a telepathic connection with somebody that you see fit, and you ask, can I have 2%, 3%, 10%, because I am so tired and I have to still get the kids from school, or I have to cook a meal, or I have clients, I have to do a healing this afternoon, this evening, this night. And most of the time I noticed that somebody, higher self, replied with, yes. Now, I dived into the whole subject a little bit deeper. That's what you do when you want to raise your children in a craft. In this case, vampirism. My oldest and I spent a lot of time in pubs and restaurants. And I think she was 13 or 14. And she wanted to know what I was working on and working with. And she had just been initiated in Reiki 1, 2, and 3. And then we were talking about vampirism, and we were in a pub, and we were sitting at a table, and in the other end, there were some girls, and I was like, okay, you want to try? And she said yes, and we sat down, and we relaxed, and I said, well, pick a girl that has something that you like, her hair, her eyes, her makeup, the way she laughs, the sound she makes when she speaks, or the way she eats, her elegance or fun, you know. And she picked a girl, and she was like, and what should I do now? And I was explaining things again, and we were like, okay, I'm going to just monitor and guide you through it, and if you have any difficulties, I will just jump in and join you. And there we were vampiring the shit out of a blonde, beautiful young woman that then fell forward with her head on the table and then disappeared underneath the table of pure exhaustion. And me and my daughter were both surprised and in shock that we were able to anyway. And I suddenly stumbled onto, that was a few weeks ago, from somebody that has a YouTube channel that was thinking that vampires shoot vampire of vampires, but not every vampire is your friend, and maybe some vampires are just, you know, insanely cruel and annoying and don't have anything that you like. So what I always have as a rule, I don't vampire out of enemies. I do psychic attacks, but I don't vampire of enemies or people I hate. And I don't vampire of friends and colleagues and students, clients, whatever. I just take models. They are on stage and the runway anyway to, you know, expose themselves and show themselves and be sexy and elegant and cool and what have you. So Dallas Cowboy cheerleaders, of course, if you are in need of some energy, you know, just look at the screen. You can use the television, computer screen, and get the energy out of the screen by watching these cheerleaders or models or things like that. So I wouldn't, I don't vampire of enemies nor friends. I leave both alone. One reason is that if you vampire of an enemy, they already are your enemy because you don't want them in your life. You don't want them in your email box. You don't want them in your life. You don't want them on your Facebook. You don't want them in your living room. You just don't want anything to do with them. So why vampire of your enemies? A psychic attack doesn't always involve vampirism. I personally don't want anything in me that belongs to an enemy because I hate these people. They are either fat and chubby and, you know, completely blinded and distorted by childhood trauma and desperation and addiction. And so I personally take models, cheerleaders, or I go into town and there are always young girls coming from school. I always vampire of girls, not for boys. I don't want to infuse myself and inhale something or feed off somebody who's male because, you know, I'm a female. why would I, you know? There are some exceptions. I will explain this later, a little bit later. So when I see young moms with babies in strollers, or girls on their bikes going home after school, or that's what I feel of. I don't know these people, and because I don't know them, I feel fine. Now the trick is, I have something in my eye. I don't know what it is. Something there. I mentioned this before. If you go through a crowd, I don't know if I mentioned this before, maybe not. If you go through a crowd, you can create multiple tendrils that work like an octopus with all those legs, and they sort of feel through the crowd, and they can give you information of if a target is suitable or healthy or not, or you know, because if you are sensitive, and you as a vampire you have to be sensitive to energies, because you don't want to accidentally swallow or feed off something that's toxic or makes you sick. That's why this David Meyer thing is, I don't know, not complete. I will read it again. However, it is possible to theorize that if a living organism could obtain and in some way use a causal energy itself, it might have no need of such causal matter as sustenance. Just as in theory, such an acquiring of a causal energy could change, that is, make more healthy and extend the causal life of such an organism. It can also, vampirism can also make you sick. It can even be lethal. It can make you die. If you feed off somebody that has cancer or a brain tumor or some kind of issue that you are not aware of, then it will ruin, can ruin your life. So what you do is, if you have decided, I'm not going to feed off enemies, I'm not going to feed off friends, just go in between, neutral path, you still have to be able to create multiple tendrils, so you can just go through a crowd feeling who has the right energy and who hasn't. Once your tendrils give you the etheric information that somebody can give you this or that or that or that, then you can lock on, suck, and once you're done, always disconnect. You have to disconnect, because if you don't, there is a Aka cord. You can call it, it's a type of Aka cord that will, you know, give away, lead away energy and lead energy towards you. And, you know, another thing you have to be very careful of is that you have to filter. You have to be sensitive. You have to filter. And why isn't there a pause button? Because something important just popped up in my mind and I don't want to do this video again. So filter, and after you're done feeding, you disconnect. Me, that's what I wanted to say. I have met certain people in my life that I see fit to be or work as permanent batteries. Now, if I go to bed, I don't let the light burn. I just, you know, use the light button and light goes off. That's how it works. The light is still there, but I am in the dark. I go upstairs, I go to bed, and next day I use the button again. So these batteries don't provide me energy long-term or permanent, let alone permanent. I just know that they are there. I know how the light switch works. If I need energy, I have 7 or 8 batteries that have been with me for a very long time. I am very picky and very selective. I'm a picky eater. I love food. I crave food. But as for going to a restaurant or something, some places you don't want to eat, you know? And some places you love to eat, you have to be picky and you have to be careful, because not all acausal or acausal energy is healthy for you. It's colored, it's tainted, and just in case you do want to vampire off an enemy, there's still something in my eyes. What's going on? It's, I think, the smartest thing to make a little gap somewhere at the base of the skull. Look for the silver cord, where the silver cord is attached to the astral and the source, and feed off that. That's the purest way, the purest form of energy you can take from somebody. But other than that, you can just take everything. Somebody's eye color, somebody's way of walking, or, you know. So I hope this makes sense. And if you have any questions, let me know, okay? See you next time. Bye.